Hey everyone, it's Alexander, the real Mr. Robinson. Welcome to the channel, and this is my review for Scoob, which, well, at one point was supposed to be the third theatrically released Scooby-Doo movie, but now it's just a regular straight-to-VOD Scooby-Doo movie, which, given the circumstances, you can't really blame them. But also, this is the first new release that I've reviewed this year since Stargirl. And basically, it's another interpretation of Scooby-Doo. In this movie, Shaggy and Scooby-Doo are abducted by the Falcon Fury and their crew, Blue Falcon, Dino Mutt, and Dee Dee Sykes, as they go on a mission to try to stop the evil Dick Dastardly, as Velma, Fred, and Daphne are trying to find out what actually happened to Scooby and Shaggy and why they got abducted. Sounds like a confusing, nonsensical plot. Well, good, because it pretty much is. Now, I don't think I'd call myself a fan of Scooby-Doo. I watched that original show, Scooby-Doo, Where Are You, a lot back when I was a kid, but that was because it was the very last cartoon right before Cartoon Friday started on Cartoon Network. It was Animaniacs, Batman the Animated Series, Scooby-Doo, Where Are You, and then Cartoon Friday. So, I've watched the show enough to really be familiar with Scooby-Doo and the tropes, and that original show is, it's very goofy. It's pretty much what Transformers is to me. It's absolutely ridiculous, it's not very well animated, there's not really a whole lot to it in terms of being a great kids cartoon, but it has a charm to it. It just occupies that special place in my heart right next to Transformers where it's so goofy and ridiculous that I just love it for what it is. And you have to give this 50-year-old series props for going through so many different interpretations while pretty much doing the exact same thing. And with this movie, it really isn't the same formulaic Mystery Inc. needs to solve a case type of movie, which actually sounds pretty refreshing when you think about it, but then again, that's actually where the movie's problems come in. I actually expected this to be somewhat decent. I mean, maybe not spectacular, but it could be funny, it could be charming in its own way, and even recapture the spirit of that original cartoon, but for a more modern audience, which is something that the live-action Scooby-Doo movie could not do. And to this day, I still don't get why that movie has developed a cult following, because it is garbage. It is just absolute crap on a stick. And like I said with this movie, it tries to do something different by bringing in characters from other Hanna-Barbera properties, like Dick Dastardly, like Dino Mutt, like the Blue Falcon. But again, that's where the movie's main problems come in, because it really turns into this giant Hanna-Barbera crossover, as if they wanted to try to do their own Avengers-style crossover. And it really doesn't feature that charm that made Scooby-Doo endear for as long as it did. And the attempt to try to make this movie for a more modern audience just feels really desperate. When the movie opens up, the very first thing that they play is California Love. And it's because of that song and the way the entire first scene plays out that I figure that this movie was going to try way too hard to appeal to a modern audience. There's a lot of other places in this movie where they just cram hip-hop songs for no reason at all, but another thing that makes this more modern approach feel forced is the terrible jokes that they make, and they're just more references to modern things that weren't around when the original cartoon was going on. For example, there's a joke about how Dick Dastardly leeches off his parents' Netflix accounts. There's a joke where Fred is compared to one of the Hemsworth brothers. There's a joke where the Blue Falcon thinks that Tinder is a log distribution company, which, that doesn't make any sense at all. Simon Cowell frequently pops up in this movie for what reason? I'm not entirely sure. And then characters start quoting movies from 20 years ago, and it's just so baffling and so confusing why they would do that, that I just said to myself, no, I am not entertained. And the script is just filled with way too many plot conveniences, and part of that is in due to the fact that there are so many other non-Scooby-Doo Hanna-Barbera characters that just pop up randomly. I mentioned Dick Dastardly, Blue Falcon, and Dino Mutt, but there are a couple others that pop up that I won't spoil. It just makes the movie feel like anything but Scooby-Doo. It feels so manufactured and forced that they wanted to make this an Avengers-style movie, but with Hanna-Barbera cartoons, and Guys, have you learned nothing from The Mummy or the early days of the DC Extended Universe? You can't force a universe onto us. You just have to build it up naturally. Now, I know there have been many Hanna-Barbera crossovers in the past, long before I was even conceived, so it's not really out of the question to do a cinematic universe for Hanna-Barbera characters, but if you're trying to do that, don't force it all into a Scooby-Doo movie. Just do what Iron Man did. Just have a cameo at the end of the movie by a different Hanna-Barbera cartoon. That way you can let the audience know without spelling it out that they're part of a bigger universe. Now, I have just dragged this movie through the mud long enough, and maybe rightfully so, but there are some things in it that I actually liked, some things that kept me from hating this movie, because I don't hate it. While all of the modern references that try to pass off as jokes are painful, there were some moments in this movie that actually made me laugh. There are some visual gags that I think are pretty funny, and the movie, throughout, incorporates those old-school Hanna-Barbera sound effects, like when characters are running, when they smash into something, and I thought that was pretty clever. It's probably the most clever thing about the movie, and if it had kept up that pace, I think it would have been pretty entertaining, but again, all those attempts to modernize the movie really hurt it. And then the voice cast is pretty good. Frank Welker voices Scooby-Doo, and again, that guy can just do any voice. You have Zac Efron as Fred, Amanda Seyfried as Daphne, Gina Rodriguez as Velma, Jason Isaacs does a good job at voicing Dick Dastardly. Will Forte as Shaggy, on the other hand, was kind of a mixed bag. There were some points where he got the Shaggy voice down completely, but there are some other points in this movie where he just didn't come across as Shaggy. And given that Shaggy is my favorite character of the entire Mystery Inc. crew, that kind of bummed me out. I think the reason he's my favorite character is because you get to make jokes about him being high, man! And then you have Ken Jeong as Dino-Mutt and Mark Wahlberg as Blue Falcon, and they're good. None of the voice actors really stand out in terms of being great. Probably Jason Isaacs is the best one. And again, I was kind of disappointed in Will Forte's Shaggy back and forth, but I mean, this movie, to sum things up, it's not completely terrible. It's just a wasted opportunity. It could have been a fantastic opportunity to try to recapture that old Scooby-Doo spirit, but because they tried to make this a giant Avengers-type crossover movie, it doesn't work. It gets away from what made Scooby-Doo so charming in the first place, whether you think that original show is good or not. And it just doesn't please anyone, in my opinion. I mean, maybe for little kids, they'll like it, but for anyone else, watch at your own risk. It's got some fun moments here and there, and there are some hints of cleverness throughout the movie, but on a whole, it's really not worth your time. Now, that being said, the evil side of me hopes that this movie kills when it comes to rentals and VOD sales, because if this movie ends up being as big of a hit, if not bigger, than Trolls World Tour, then I can't wait to see what AMC is going to say about this. Are they going to boycott Warner Brothers the same way they're boycotting Universal at a time where they're showing no movies at all? So I can't wait to see what AMC's follow-up to this is, if Scoob ends up being a big success. And there you go, that's my review for Scoob. Now I want to know what you guys think about the movie. If you've seen it, what did you think? Whatever the case may be, let me know in the comments below. And until next time, I hope you enjoyed this review. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, give this video a like, leave a comment, support my Patreon page, follow me on social media, and until then, this is the real Mr. Robinson telling you there's only one.